Segment of the show for today. The guest is Dr. Bobby Levitt from Tennessee State University, and the topic is the 150th year commemoration of the Civil War, or the sesquicentennial of the war. And of course, Dr. Levitt, let's talk about members of the sesquicentennial heritage foundation that, right. that you're working with.
Well, the sesquicentennial commission consists of a large number of people from cross sections of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. I served on that for perhaps a year, mm-hmm. But I'm no longer on that. But it's under the Commissioner of Tourism, mm-hmm. and she has done a marvelous job in making sure that this celebration in Tennessee, this commemoration, mm-hmm. is inclusive. Mm-hmm. And then there is the Tennessee Civil War Heritage Committee, okay. mm-hmm. which I serve as an advisor mm-hmm. on, advisory committee headed by Carol Van West of mm-hmm. MTSU. Those two committees are very important in pushing this commemoration across mm-hmm. the state of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. And I think Tennesseans are going to learn that Tennessee was very much involved mm-hmm. in this historic event. Especially by 1864, when the Battle of Nashville was fought in mm-hmm. December 15th through 19th, 1864, mm-hmm. which Tennessee historian Stanley Horn says was one of the decisive battles mm-hmm. in the Civil War. It was a turning point. Mm-hmm. And at the end of 1864, when people were tired of the war, mm-hmm. the Union needed a victory. Mm-hmm. And the Confederates tried to retake Nashville mm-hmm. as a strategic city. And the commanding general, George Thomas, collected about 42,000 troops here, mm-hmm. and including maybe as much as 10,000 of them mm-hmm. were United States colored troops, mm-hmm. or what we call USCT. Mm-hmm. As you know, we have a commemoration each year in December on Kwame Lillett and others. Out at the National Cemetery mm-hmm. on Gallatin Road mm-hmm. To remember what those men did, mm-hmm. those African-American soldiers mm-hmm. and others, because there are almost 2,000 black Civil War soldiers buried mm-hmm. in the National Cemetery mm-hmm. on Gallatin Road next to Kmart. Mm-hmm. And that kind of ended the Confederates' real efforts. Mm-hmm. From then on, they're on the run. Mm-hmm. And on January 31st, mm-hmm. the House of Representatives proposed the 13th Amendment to mm-hmm. the Constitution. And the House of Representatives mm-hmm. passed a proposal. Mm-hmm. The Senate had already passed that proposal in December mm-hmm. at the end of the Battle of Nashville. And on February 1st, Lincoln is so happy, he says, mm-hmm. that is a king's proposal. Mm-hmm. That sums the whole thing up. Mm-hmm. Because what he wanted was a permanent amendment that would put his Emancipation Proclamation mm-hmm. in stone. Mm-hmm. And as you know, Lincoln was assassinated the next April, mm-hmm. 1865. Mm-hmm. But prior to that, on the 3rd of April, Lincoln is able 4th of April, Lincoln is able to visit the Confederate capital mm-hmm. because General Lee says mm-hmm. to President Davis, mm-hmm. you better get out of here. We can't hold it anymore. Mm-hmm. They evacuate Richmond. Lincoln arrives on boat with his son, Tad. Mm-hmm. A black carriage driver okay. escorts mm-hmm. him through Richmond. Mm-hmm. On the same day, and this is some of Lincoln's doing, black soldiers are the first to enter Richmond mm-hmm. and stand sentry at the Confederate mm-hmm. White House as a symbol.
He
wanted to make it a symbol. Mm-hmm. Slavery is over, mm-hmm. and black people had a lot to do with the mm-hmm. ending of it. So among General Grant's 100,000 troops, 25,000 mm-hmm. of the Army of the James are black soldiers mm-hmm. under General Grant outside Richmond. Mm-hmm. And he tells the white soldiers to stand aside, and they stand aside, and the black soldiers come up front mm-hmm. so that they will symbolically be mm-hmm. among the first mm-hmm. to enter the captured Confederate mm-hmm. Capital, Richmond, Virginia. Slavery is over. Mm-hmm. The war is over. The Union, of course, has mm-hmm. been restored, maintained, and blacks had a lot to do with it. That's why they're going to owe blacks the 14th Amendment to make them citizens, the 15th Amendment, 1870, to give them the right to vote. And they're basing it on these blacks made a tremendous sacrifice to save the Union and to end slavery. 200,000 of them served in the Union Army, 20% of all Union soldiers, and 20,000 African Americans served in the Union Navy. So they were saying and protesting at the end of the war, we have a stake in being citizens. For the first time, the United States does something unusual. It passes the 14th Amendment in 1868, making all persons born in the United States citizens. Doesn't mention race, but it means that the former slaves ought to be citizens too. Whereas, remember, they had taken Native Americans and placed them in reservations and would not make them citizens, you know. But overnight, blacks became citizens of the United States as a result of the Civil War.
And so in real